What's up, everybody? I'm CeramicWeasel, and as you can see, I am back here in the Institute. I am about to go talk to Father about the Battle of Bunker Hill, because now that I've done some of the Minutemen stuff and they are starting to get set up, I think we can continue on with the main plotline fairly safely. So let's just get this out of the way.
Hello, Father.
Oh.
Tell me, what would you do when someone has stolen from you?
Ooh, I would talk to them. I think you already know. Oh, yeah.
After everything I've been through to find you, I think you already know.
I'm sorry, Father. Of course. You're right. The group that calls themselves the Railroad have acquired several synths from the Institute. Synths that had gone missing in recent months. They no doubt mean to free these synths, in their delusion that synths are somehow sentient beings. You've been in contact with the Railroad, so you're aware of their misguided beliefs?
Yeah, I've never heard of them. They mean well, they're only... Okay.
They mean well. They're only doing what they think is right.
You dealt with Libertalia. That's the result of their selfish, short-sighted plan. Usually they are a minor nuisance, but lately they have become more emboldened. I'm afraid we've reached the point where a response is necessary. We have learned the current location of these synths and need to reacquire them before the Railroad can hide them.
I'm not sure why you'd bother.
I'm not sure why you'd bother.
Aside from taking back our property, we must teach them a lesson, as it were, and quickly at that. But it's important that we act on this soon, before the Railroad has any indication we've tracked them. We also don't want the Brotherhood of Steel getting wind of the presence of the synths. That would only complicate
things. Yeah, I can imagine. Oh, all right. Yeah, whatever.
I'll act quickly. You can count on me.
You'll have a contact waiting for you just outside Bunker Hill. Good luck.
Thank you. And I found it really weird how this guy named Father is calling me Father. So what have I got? Options. I have the option to inform the Railroad or the Brotherhood of Steel, or both, I presume. And I probably will go talk to the Railroad about this. Yeah, okay, so let's get out and about. There's a bunch of stuff that I've done and I want to talk to you guys about, so what do we got? Reach Bunker Hill, inform the Railroad, inform the Brotherhood of Steel. Okay, so yeah, I'd feel bad if I didn't inform the Railroad that somebody was about to sort of bust into their hideout and take the synths, so I will go talk to them about it. I don't really give a damn about the Brotherhood of Steel, to be perfectly honest. They're just gonna cause trouble by barging in there and shooting the place up and killing all the synths, so that's not desirable. So there are a few things that I have done since my last episode. So one thing is that I've picked up this guy, Deacon, and I got rid of the other dude, MacReady, because he was a big annoyance. He was getting on my nerves, and I just decided to get his quest out of the way, which I did do, and got his companion perk, which is awesome, by the way. I was able to get rid of him. I think I sent him back to the castle to help defend it and stuff. I don't know. That's one thing I have done, and hopefully, you know, this Deacon guy, he's pretty cool. I don't know whether we're gonna have time to do his affinity stuff and get his perk, because we're approaching the end of the game, I think, particularly if I ignore all the side quests and just sort of go straight for it. I think we can get this wrapped up pretty quickly. So I don't think I will get very far with Deacon, but he's cool to have around, and I like him as a companion. He's got some pretty awesome dialogue and commentary on things as they happen. So, you know, we're just going to stick with him and hope for the best. Now, I have given him some equipment. So, he's got ballistic weave stuff and he's got the deliverer. So, I assume he's going to be at least somewhat helpful in a fight. I don't think the deliverer is an especially good gun for a companion because it's the modifications on it are for like VATS. It's got, you know, VATS enhancement stuff, which is not I don't know. I assume companions don't use VATS, and I don't think that's going to be very useful. But you know, whatever. It's got pretty good damage, so we'll just let him get on with that, and hopefully hopefully he will be pretty useful. So there's another thing that I have done, aside from like all the quests and stuff for MacReady, and I have set up the castle a little bit, put up some defenses, fixed the breaks in the wall. I will go back there at some point and show you guys what I've done. It's not all that exciting, really. It's pretty simplistic, but what was that? Did you guys see that? That flash? That was like a nuclear explosion happening, right? I don't know. So
peaceful, but no one's sane goes inside.
Yes. Well, I'm far from sane. So the other thing I've done is I've been messing around with the mods a little bit. You may have seen in my conversation with Shaun/Father that the conversation dialogue mod that I originally had, probably not in this Let's Play, it was probably before this Let's Play, the one that I preferred but didn't work with Survival when I tried to install it the first time, I've got that back, which is awesome because I really disliked the other one that I was trying to use. It hardly ever showed the full sentence dialogue, which is the only reason why I installed the damn thing in the first place. So I went ahead and tried the one I prefer again, and it appears to have been fixed for survival difficulty, which is really helpful. So I've done that, and whilst I was like out looking for mods, I went and grabbed a whole bunch of other ones. I'm not sure if you guys have noticed an improvement or anything in the graphics, but I've got a whole bunch of high resolution textures and stuff now for the ground and for buildings and general environmental stuff. I don't know whether it does much for the characters like NPCs and things, but there is certainly a whole bunch of improved texture files. It was an enormous download. That should be a dramatic improvement on the graphics, I think. Which, you know, I appreciate. And I've done a couple of other ones. No, see, here we go. Here we go. This is the one problem I have with some of the mods is that they don't quite work out how you want them to. Sometimes there's slight little glitches that slip through, but I'm not sure if it's any worse than the original game, or well, maybe slightly, but the original game had its own problems as well, so yeah, I don't know. But yeah, aside from the texture mods, I've installed a couple of others, which will probably come up. I've installed something called True Storms, which makes the thunderstorms and radstorms and all the other kind of stormy stuff way more intense. It's actually kind of freaking me out a little bit whenever there's a storm, because I was running around with MacReady with that installed for a little while, and yeah, that's some serious intensification of the storms in the Commonwealth. So we'll probably see a little bit of that in action at some point, either in this episode or maybe the next one. I don't know how long it's going to take for a storm to suddenly whip up and take everybody by surprise, but we'll get around to it eventually. So I'm just going to stop off at the railroad before I head to Bunker Hill to let them know what's going on, and hopefully we can.
Diamond City is under opposition control.
Hopefully we can set up
there, assume you're being watched.
Some kind of plan.
Bet you never met a synth before Glory.
I don't know why Drummer Boy keeps coming.
I heard the most fascinating rumor. The story goes that you actually found the Institute. Been there and back again.
Oh.
Sounds crazy, right?
Yeah, no, that's totally nuts.
That sounds crazy, all right.
That's not a denial. Deacon has proof you used teleportation, of all things, to get inside the Institute. You must feel justifiably proud of what your Minutemen have achieved in such a short time. Eventually, the Minutemen will devise their own plan to deal with the Institute. But I doubt your soldiers will place any priority on rescuing the synths inside. I'm counting on you being as passionate about freeing synths as we are. Please, work with us instead.
Oh,
You think the Minutemen won't help the synths?
The Minutemen are a reflection of the character of the Commonwealth people. And time again, that character has been proven to be rotten.
Ooh.
The synths are tangible receptacles of their hatred of the Institute. Order them to help, and they'd mutiny.
I don't know.
Take your time. Think it over. But remember, the synth's fate is literally in your hands.
Glad you're with us.
So, how do I... Can I inform you? Oh, yeah.
Desdemona.
Please, work with us instead of the Minutemen. The lives of many synths are at stake.
Are you going to make me choose right now, then? I'm going to go with the Minutemen.
I'll stick with my people and the Minutemen.
Of course I'm disappointed. But hopefully in time you'll come around. The fate of the synths depends on it.
What? No, I've got something more important to talk to you about.
Please, work with us instead of the Minutemen. The lives of many synths are at stake.
No! No! Am I not going to have the option to talk to her about this other thing until I agree with this? This seems like a bug. Fine.
I'll work with you then.
You have no idea how relieved I am to hear that. What I'm about to tell you is the most closely guarded secret the railroad has. It's time you learn about Patriot. There's a man, or woman, we're not sure, inside the Institute who helps synths escape to freedom. Dozens of synths owe him their lives. We don't know his name. We've never had a way to contact him. So we gave him the codename Patriot. So you need to infiltrate the Institute and make contact with Patriot.
Oh, boy.
Contacting him is going to be tricky.
Fortunately, Tom has come up with a potential way to do it. We can plant a coded message on an Institute terminal. And, if all goes well, he'll respond. Just see Tom, and you can proceed from there.
I've got more important things. Yes, yes. Here.
The Institute knows about Bunker Hill. They're planning to recapture the synths there.
The timing couldn't be worse. The old man's been sitting on those four synths. There's nowhere else that's safe we could put them. Maintaining your cover is vital. But this, the sacrifice is just too great.
How much damage would it cause if we let them hit us?
We're running out of places to hide our synths. That's why we put so many eggs in one crowded basket to begin with. So what would we lose? Four synths, Stockton, some of our best agents, and the inevitable civilian casualties? No, not this time. We've never known when and where the Institute would strike us next. But now we have a chance to turn the tables. We wait until the enemy is in position, then we hit them hard. No one they send out comes back alive except you. Understand?
Well, that would possibly blow my cover. Is that all? Yeah. Yeah. This one. totally this one.
Won't the Institute be suspicious if I'm the only one left?
You're a lot tougher than anyone else in their outfit. If only one person could survive, it would be you. And any story you come up with won't be contradicted. We can't attack too early. We need to draw them into the kill zone and then spring the trap. You'll know when. You'll probably have a courser escort. You'll have to take him down. You've done it before, but it'll still be dangerous.
Sure. Okay. Yeah, okay.
Like you said, I've done it before.
It's a risk, but it's one we have to take. So get it done.
Just get it done. Just get it done. So I'm supposed to go talk to Tinker Tom as well. Maybe I should eat something as well. What have I got? Oh yeah, I made a bunch of Myalurk egg omelets. Apparently they only weigh 0.1 pounds, so they're super light and easy to carry around. Ooh, wait, I totally ate too much of that, but okay.
Oh man, you were actually there? Inside the belly of the beast? No time for that though. Let's set you up to contact Patriot. I got here one genuine Tinker Tom special. Just load her up onto a holotape. Plug her into any Institute terminal and execute.
Wow. Okay.
Hey, it's Bullseye. Bullseye's back.
Yeah. So this actually changes things.
Have you met with Patriot yet?
No, go away. No, I have not met with Patriot yet. This changes things, because if I go and do Bunker Hill now and I do what I'm intending to do in that whole thing, then I will not have the opportunity to go contact Patriot anymore, and that will kind of mess things up, I think. Maybe I should go do that beforehand. Oh, I didn't consider this at all. I didn't expect that Desdemona would be so adamant about not talking to me until I agree to help them with their method of doing things. And I don't think that ties me down. I don't have to go along with their plan, but that was frustrating. So I guess I could just ignore it. I guess I could. I don't know. Decisions. Okay. Yeah, I think I will, because it's just going to be a hassle to go all the way back to the Institute now and then make my way all the way back here, because if I'm not mistaken, Bunker Hill, yeah, it's really close by. I'd have to teleport back into there, then teleport back out, then run all the way. No, okay, forget that. We are not going to do things their way. We are not going to mess around with that in any way, shape, or form. We're just going to do this with the Minutemen like we had planned and ignore all the side quests from both the Railroad and the Brotherhood of Steel, because that would be counterproductive. Yes, counterproductive to my eventually completing this. Oh, okay, so I'm supposed to meet with this courser. Okay, are we ready? Are we good to go? We've got armor on, all my good armor. I've got my weapons. I'm a little bit low on ammunition, to be honest. I'm somewhat concerned, but well, yeah, let's deal with this. I hope you don't mind this guy with me.
I've been waiting for you.
Good. What's your tone, Synth? yeah.
So, what's our situation?
I assume you've been briefed. Our targets are inside. 4 Synths under railroad protection. Majority of the settlement is uninvolved and are expected to run for cover. The situation appears to have escalated. A covert approach is likely impossible. We move in, secure the Synths, and I relay out with them back to the Institute. Clear?
Sure. Yeah, okay.
Let's get going already.
Affirmative.
This mission's gonna be a lot of fun, courser buddy.
Here are the recall codes. Follow me.
We're getting shot at!
Just changed. We're going shooting.
They were just here.
Since when are there raiders here? What is going on?
What is this?
When did that happen? Oh, okay, so we got Synths and Railroad guys. Okay, and that that sounds like a vertibird. When did the Brotherhood of Steel get wind of this? I didn't realize that, wow. Can I just ignore you guys? How do I do this? Oh, I'm tired. Come on. There we go. Okay. Alright, I'm in danger apparently. Why? Is somebody... What is going on? Oh my goodness. I have no idea whether I should be helping anybody out or what. So these are railroad agents. Okay, so that's Kessler. No, we don't need to worry about her. What else is happening? Is it just railroad? Oh! Whoa, okay. Yeah, this is getting a little bit dangerous. Alright, let's just carry on with the plan. Wow, okay. How do I get in here? Oh, okay. Oh, what's this? Join the railroad. No, I've already done that. Okay. Wow, okay, so it's really, it's really intense out there, jeez. Whoa. I can't help either of you. Maybe I should. What has he got anyway? So they're pretty well armored, actually. See, this is interesting. So he's got a laser rifle and a hunting rifle. You see, I had this guy tell me that all the railroad heavies are equipped with Gauss rifles during this, and I keep telling him no, they're not. It's totally level dependent, and they are not. Oh, is that Brotherhood of Steel? Am I gonna have to fight some Brotherhood? Wow. Okay, let's... I think I'm just gonna have to kill everyone. Synths. Railroad heavies. We've got Brotherhood of Steel guys somewhere. Alright, this is getting annoying. I'm gonna have to kill some synths, I think. Star Paladin? I think we're gonna have to kill some of the Brotherhood of Steel. Aren't you dying? Yeah, I think we're gonna have to do something about the Brotherhood of Steel here, guys. I assume that this isn't gonna make me an enemy of the Brotherhood, right? Oh my goodness. What are these guys firing at? What are they? Oh, they're firing at this guy. Yeah, you know, we should probably kill this guy, right? Speak to Father in the ruins. Okay. I'm not sure about this. I'm kind of winging it at the moment. I really don't know whether or not this is the right way to do things. I don't have any particular loyalties to any of these groups, right? Because I'm going with the Minutemen, right? So I'm think I'm fairly safe to just... Ooh, Gatling laser. Okay. I think I'm safe to just basically kill anybody who gets in my way, but because I kind of agree to... Ooh, what is this? No, it's nothing good. I kind of agree to help out the railroad with this and get their synths out, and I'm kind of keen to also make myself an enemy of the Institute. It's just that the Brotherhood of Steel are just getting in the way. I have no real option, I think, other than to... Ooh. No, that's friendly. Okay. Yes. I have no real option, I think, other than to just kill any Brotherhood of Steel guys who get in my way. I don't think it's going to put me in a situation where I'm enemy with the Brotherhood of Steel. I am hoping not. But I think I can get away with killing pretty much anybody in this fight. And it's just going to get all taken down to friendly fire, chaos kind of nonsense happening with... deal with the escape synths. Okay. How do I deal with this?
Hey there.
I can't believe you do that for us. Thank you.
Yes.
I can't believe you do that for us. Thank you.
Hi.
You've given us another chance at life. We won't forget it.
So, hang on. What am I supposed to be doing? Deal with the escape synths. Speak to Father in the ruins of CIT. So...
Thank you for sparing us.
Okay. So, when I killed the Corsair, it just automatically flagged these guys as having been rescued? Is that the thing?
Hey there.
We'll get somewhere safe as soon as you're gone.
Oh, okay. Okay. Fine. So I guess I didn't really need to come in here after all.
I don't know if even a scaver would take that.
Hey, come on, Deacon. Wow. Okay. Wow. I thought I had to go talk to them and say, "Hey, you're free to go. I'm totally on your side, etc. But yeah, apparently, as soon as you turn on the Corsair. Okay. I guess that's it then. I guess we go talk to Father. And carry on with what we were intending to do right from the beginning. That was kind of anticlimactic, to be a little bit honest. I was expecting some like crazy showdown where I'd have to really consider my decision, really think about it, And have the ramifications of it sort of wash over me in this great big, "You have made a decision." But no, it's nothing like that. The chaos of the battle and everything just taking place like that. So what are you shooting at?
Let's do this.
That was Trashcan Carla. Trashcan Carla? Are you here? Oh, look, it is. It's Trashcan Carla. Whose side is she on, I wonder? Oh. That was a... wow. Okay. Maybe I should get out of here. I thought that maybe I was... Why are they shooting Kessler? What are these railroad heavies doing? This is weird. Oh, wow, synths. Okay. No, look, forget it. Forget it. I'm done. I'm just done. Oh, man. So I guess I could go around murdering Brotherhood of Steel guys and synths and all kinds of stuff, and stealing all their equipment. That would be one thing I could do. but honestly, I don't really care about their equipment. Ooh, what is this? Night Sergeant. They don't seem particularly interested. I like how there are just super mutants lying around. Sure, whatever. Okay, so I need to get back to the Institute ruins. It might be easier for me to just teleport to the Institute. And then teleport out of the Institute back to the ruins. That would be a lot simpler. And hey, while I'm here...
From what I hear, that rogue scent at Libertalia was a real menace. Glad it's back where it belongs.
While I'm here... Yeah, okay, so maybe I can do the whole...
You could have known Father as
the whole thing with what's-his-face? The Patriot guy, right? I need to find a terminal. There's a bunch in here that I tucked away in somewhere.
It's great to have you.
Fairly secretive, I believe, that I can get away with doing this on the sly. What do we do? How do we do this? I need to load a holotape. I need... this is my true Storms configuration. Okay, so when I installed that mod, it gives me these holotapes to change some of the stuff. And maybe... Yeah, okay, so I can go over that as well in a moment. But hang on, let me just... sort out. Is this it? Encrypted message? Transmitting. Message from Tom. Copy encrypted message? Huh? So here it is. Short version. Oh, yeah, okay. So I just need to copy the encrypted message. Alright. Blah, blah, blah. Read Patriot's reply. Wow, that was fast. Read urgent reply. Acknowledged. Meet at advanced systems maintenance room. That was really fast. He must be online all the time. Okay. Just constantly checking his messages. It's like a Facebook junkie or something. But yeah, okay, so there are like configuration options for the True Storms and some of the other mods that they have, which change like the game mechanics a little bit. So, you know, it gives you the option of decreasing detection rates or detection distances, etc. When there's a storm going on, things like that. I haven't actually enabled any of them because I'm kind of iffy about changing game mechanics. I don't know. It's something I haven't done before. And I'm not really sure I should ever do that. But I'm okay with changing just like visuals and interface stuff. Possibly sounds and everything, but I don't know. What do you guys think about changing the gameplay mechanics with mods? Is that going too far? Is that sort of like going down the slippery slope to cheating, or are you guys okay with that? Let me know in the comments. Anyway,
it's me. So you're the one who sent the encrypted message. How did you even do that? I wasn't sure anyone on the surface would have a chance to crack Trinity. You know. The encryption algorithm.
No, I know nothing about that. Yeah.
I'm not sure I should trust you.
You're worried about me? If the SRB cracked Trinity? Man, your message was only one word. Friend. What did you mean by that?
Oh, that was it? That's all you sent, Tom? Wow, okay.